Shaka, son of Zenzangakona the Faithless, of Mandy the Outcast. Zulu, right arm of Dingin's Wild, shelter of men, women, their children, the people. Stabbed by Mutanga, who turns my own strength against me, who kills me from behind, who's thrust at my left bicep. Zangakona broke my mother's flesh. He played and promised her chiefs could do no wrong. A Zulu chief was nothing then. My mother was nothing. She bled the black shell of a beetle. Ishaka, he said, was swelling inside her. Down I was dropped on dull earth. The unwanted son. Sent to watch the outermost herd. The shoulder hunch of having no home and no patience, teased in the shade of cat. From tribe to tribe to tribe, she and I wandered. Refugees were not welcome. The scurrying days of low-bellied hunger between skirmishes and squabbles, lily roots and mud. The way other crowds caught fire was no. Once at Erengeli, a gray, black-mouthed mamba came for me, telling me to be a man, telling me these were mine, and a fang of death.
Mine.
I crushed that panting limb under hiss of pain on every man's behalf. Once at Jobi's kraal, at 19, my front apron rising with sap. In the days when men like you stood back, blew assegais into nowhere and called that I walked into a leather chief's skin and thrust that brittle spear down his throat that lesser people like you might be spared. Once, you remember, our first disorganized raid. And for all our swearing, the mad Dacha-blown giant scrambled us in fear. In his presence, even I was undersized. But I punctured him to open our way. I know that first cry of another's blood. With the Ezekwe, the bush regiment, singling out a man on Dingis Wire's other side, his ribs a beating target, and my own heart's trap. I know the sucker blade as he goes down eating her. Then a young fighter had to wipe death in a woman's thighs. There was this following girl, Pampata, on my dappled shield, her veins like tomorrow's blood. That was when I knew the bursting of my life. The bellows opened a flame, a shaft of iron in the blast, at Ngonyama's place, the melting down of all our weaponry. One stabbing spear. Chanting the cackling of destiny over the house. What followed was roughly correct. Senzangakona finally died. Dingane, you were there when I was sworn head of the
house.
You were nothing. 500 medium strong. There was no ambition until the measuring of every man as I ordered him to stand like sugarcane. Huts with not much industry. Dust from splayed hoofs and reed fences. Like the one you hide behind. Pastoral, I suppose, but far too humble to satisfy. The place of killing was hardly alive. Slip their curly guts out and let their spirits fly. Dance high, my people. Hyenas wait on us behind. If you want to be people of heaven, dance higher. Look, the ground is spiky with devil thorns. I have my sandals off. Dance over them, my people. As the natural thorn hardens your soul, dance higher. He told me there'd be time before a pale imported machine came galloping round my fields of blood. He told of a tree spreading taller. First beat Matuani. Clutched around the chest, upward thrust below his multitude of fat. Then Sweedy, collector of skulls. My Fasimba boys in perfect ranks. Close like secateurs of spinal cords. And off with their rolling heads. You were there, Dingane, when our Dingus Wild died like a god. His grave is the end of a furrow that grows your new king. Like a great fig tree, I stand over the earth. My roots are calcium. There is more blood in my stem than an elephant's. My branches cover the sky. I carry protection. And my head is the sun. Your brother, you who hack my navel, I tell you, stuck with you. And as I stride from my throne across the trust of my court, Zululand shakes with me. You don't believe that I am God? This spurt out of my lungs had a God's power. I will get it over with. When the royal sun was eclipsed, I stood before it and spat the blackness out. And the sun was reborn. With Shoshongani, we needed no sun. What better celebration than hunting my elephant? We beat royal herds of impala, pig, lion, leopard, the elephant. Across a cleft of the white and black Umfolozi, we hamstrung such elephant. The Portuguese want more ivory. See to it. It's your one mistake. All my elephants tumble down.
Impolo! Impolo!
The earth was endless that year. You had a god who saw to it. When the great core of the Mdubu tree opened and Zululand grew heavy with first fruits, swelling of beer, exasperated cramming of granaries and stomachs. The world reeled out of absence, and my sisters clicked pink palates. You must admit that took some discipline. 1,200 black virgins to be loved by me. I don't think I can be satisfied. My ceremonial bath before the courts seemed like a new Shaka rose in Schneider. Held by laws, like gravity, together to our stretching soul. Why should a hub of the just unbalance in front of the sun? I tripped his baby's heels and swung his brains on the ground. And impaled all retrograde witches. The women with nostrils and bites smelling like a jealousy. On schools. Of taking the end of the world, the ocean steered my impulse into a shell in the sand. A sailing ship. And I. Circled my new Kavala wire on playing horses and playing sunlight. They were entertaining. Farewell. Finn. Isaacs. With fingers for skins and conviction that shaking hands made a bargain. They were not that impressed with women, route marches, raids, shows of bravery. So I signed a meticulous document. Gave them Durban Bluff, Berrier, Congella to tie their king's anchor. It was a time for compromise. We moved to this halfway, Dukuza, towards the Britannic Majesty, my Georgie, whose swallows always return. They promised us everlasting life. But Nandi died, crying, Baba, 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 Mame, Mame, Mame. A wave of brown and all Zululand died. She was the clay and the stream. She was the life in the root. She was the suckling river. Dry. I conquered the world. Let the bit. tears on every warrior's cheeks. Do not touch broken mealies, thin cattle, cracking pots. Do not hold wives, husbands, bread udders for grief. Wail, my people, for she who let us live is dead. You have no vision, Mbopa, my deadly counselor. I sent diplomatic gifts, not to stand in a trader's shadow, not to rustle their mongrel cattle, but that your children be theirs too, Mbopa. King Georgie returned me his cash, a mirror, a copper, a bead. Is it for that black muscle will dock ships, work factories, tar roads, unearth gold, clutter and smoke out locations? King Georgie, he sent me his trash. A mirror, a copper, a bead. Only this morning, a new brother. I grew tired of the killing. When an old Zulu praised his judge, Shaka, my king, he said, your name, Shaka, Zulu, will live. And I let him live. Only this morning I cried for my people, Mbopa. A land without restless men. My tears are cloudbursts when sniveling pondos brought crane feathers for a king and this cloak of skin for peace. You mean three crouched for your own good. No hyenas will touch my flesh. For you, Dingane, kill your king, Mbopa, please. For letting you live. Stab your Shaka, son of Sensangakona, of Nandi, Zulu, successor of Dingiswayo. Shelter